Good morning students, welcome to 5th math class. Today we will start chapter number 5, decimal fractions. Students, what are decimal fractions? The numbers having decimal, for example 7.56, 8.98, these numbers are called decimal fractions. There are two types of decimals. The first one are like decimal fractions and the second are unlike decimal fractions. For example, 6.37, 118.82 and 309.09. In these three figures, see, there are two decimal places after decimal. This is 10th place, this is 100th place, again this is 10th place, this is 100th place, again 10th, and this is 100. So, in these three figures, there are two decimal places after the decimal. So, these are like decimal fractions. These all are like decimal fractions. And unlike decimal fractions, for example, 5.409, 7.82 and 1.3. In these three figures, see, in the first figure, there are three decimal places. Tens, hundred, thousands. And here, only two decimal places, here only one decimal places. So these three are unlike decimal fractions because these decimal fractions have different decimal places. Now let's start exercise 5.1. First sum from the exercise 5.1, A part 16.23. This fraction we have to write in words. First we write the place value of each digit. 1 stands, this is 16, 16, afterward there is decimal, so write decimal, and after decimal give name to the each digit on the decimal, different decimal places separately. This is 2, then 3, this is not 23, don't write 23, this is 2, 3. 16 decimal 23. Same sum number A 103005. Its name is 103. Then decimal, write decimal. And after decimal, three digits are there. Give name to them separately. 0. Then again 0, then is 5. So this is the name of this decimal fraction, 103 decimal 005. Now second question, write each decimal as a decimal, write each fraction as a decimal. The fraction is 7 over 10. Students, see on the denominator, there is 10, it has 10. So that's why there will be one decimal place after decimal. It will be 7 decimal. You can write decimal 7 or 0.0 decimal 7. Same part number F, 1 3 over 10. There is denominator has 1 0 10. So that's why there will be one decimal place, 1 decimal 3. Now third sum, write the decimals as mixed numbers. Statement 3.54. We have to change this into mixed fraction. This is whole number part, so write 3. Then this is decimal part, 54. There are two decimal places, so 54 over 100. There will be two zeros with 1 because there are two decimal places. Where the decimal will come, there 1 will come, and this is 0, 0. So 3 is the whole number part, 54 over 100. Now see the next part. Write place value of underlined digit. 1 decimal 0, 3, 6. Firstly write the place value of each digit. This is 10th, this is 100th place, this is thousandth place. And for in the first sum, we have to write the place value of underlined digit 3. So write 300th, or you can write 3/100. Now, fifth part, write the following decimals in expanded form. 3.752. We have to change this into, this is C part, we have to change this into expanded form. First, we write the place value for each digit. This is 10th, this is 100th, this is 1000th. So, 3 is the whole number part, write 3 plus 7 over 10 plus 5 over 100 plus 2 over 1000. So, this is expanded form of this decimal fraction. Now, sixth part, write the decimal for the following. A part, decimal fraction in the expanded form is already given to you and you have to change it into decimal form. Firstly, see place value of each digit. This is 10th, this is 100, this is 1's, sorry, this is 1's, this is 10th, and this is 100. And this is 10th, this is 100th, and this is 1000th place. So this will become 327 decimal. 10th place digit is 0, 100th place digit is 1, and here 1000th place digit is 3. So this is changed into decimal fraction. 327 decimal 013. Now, seventh part, you have to write symbol greater than or less than. For example, C part 13.59. In the box, you have to put this symbol 8.099. Students, while comparing two decimal fractions, firstly, we compare the whole number part. This is whole number part, and the decimal fraction having greater whole number part is greater. Here there is 13, here is 8, which one is greater? 13. So this whole fraction, decimal fraction is greater. And now the second part number E, 0.135, 0.307. And students, if the decimal fractions have whole number parts same or zero, then we compare the decimal fractions by their 10th place digits. Here 10th place digit is 1 and here 10th place digit is 3. So this fraction is greater. Understood? If the 10th place digits are same, then we compare the decimal fractions by their 100th place and so on. Now, part number 10, convert the common fractions into decimal fractions. Common fraction is 1 by 2, B, 1 by 10. Students, to convert a common fraction into decimal fraction, we convert or we change the decimal fraction into a decimal fraction whose denominator is 10 or multiple of 10, means 10, 100,000. Here you can convert this into 1 by 2 into 1 by into the decimal fraction having denominated 10, because on the table of 2, 10 comes. And on which number 10 comes, to get that number, divide 10 with 2, you will get 5. So multiply numerator and denominator with 5. You will get 5 over 10. And afterward, change this fraction into decimal fraction, it will be will become 0.5. Now 1 by 4. But you cannot change this 4 into 10 because on the table of 4, 10 doesn't come. But on the table of 4, the multiple of 10, 100 come. So 100 will on the denominator. But on which number 100 comes, to get that number, divide 100 with 4. You will get 25. So multiply numerator and denominator with 25. So 25 over 100 afterward change into decimal fraction, it will become 0.25. Understood? So now the 11th part, last part of this exercise. Convert the decimal fraction into common fraction. Decimal fraction is already given to you. Now you have to convert into common fraction. Here one place value after the decimal, so 3 over 10. And you cannot change into this into simplest form because 3 and 10 has no common factor. Now B part 0.6. 6 over 10 will come and you can simplify this because 6 and 10 has common factor 2. So cut on the table of 2, 3 over 5. This is your answer. Now let's start exercise 5.2. 5.2 exercise is based on the multiplication of decimal by a whole number. 5.2 exercise. First B part. Students, to multiply a decimal by a whole number. See, this is decimal part and this is called multiplicand. And 16 is multiplier. Firstly, multiply decimal fraction by a whole number. We perform multiplication as we multiply whole numbers. Here 3948, after 856, after addition 10058 will be the answer. But put the decimal point in the product to get as many decimal places as there are in the multiplicand. See, in the multiplicand there are two decimal places, 1, 2. So put the decimal after, before two decimal places, 1, 2 decimal will be here. So this is your answer, 105.28. Now let's start exercise 5.3, which is based on the multiplication of decimal by 10, 100 and 1000. For example, multiplication of 0.4 with 10. To multiply a decimal fraction by 10, the decimal will be moved one place to the right. Because 10 has 10, so decimal point will be placed one place to the right. And answer will be 4 decimal, and after decimal you can put 0 or you can write 4 answer. Next, to multiply this decimal fraction with 10, again decimal point is moved one place to the right. So your answer will be 0.8. Part number K. To multiply a decimal fraction by 100, the decimal point will be moved two places to the right because 100 has 2 zeros. So 1, 3, 1, 4, 5 decimal, and after decimal you can put 0, and if you don't want to put 0 then you can only write 1, 31, 4, 5. Now part number S, to multiply a decimal with 1000, then decimal will be moved two places to the right. Students, see, in this sum only two places are there after decimal. So to get 3 decimal places you can put 0 here, and after decimal will be shifted here. So your answer will be 90 decimal, and after decimal you can put 0. If you don't want to put decimal, only 90 is your answer. Now exercise 5.4, which is based on the multiplication of decimal by a decimal. For example, 14.6 and 0.23. This is called multiplicand and this is multiplier. Students, to multiply a decimal by a decimal, we perform multiplication as we multiply whole numbers, simply whole numbers. Firstly, multiply 146 with 3, you will get this. Then, after addition, you know how to multiply. Afterward, in the product, put the decimal to get as many decimal places as there are in the multiply candle and multiplier together. Here, one decimal place, here two, so together are 1, 2, 3. So put 1, 2, 3, put decimal here to get 3 decimal places after decimal. This is your answer. Now, last exercise 5.5, which is based on the properties of multiplication. The first property, C statement. Students, when we multiply two decimal fractions or a decimal fraction by a whole number, the order of factors doesn't affect the product. On the left hand side there is 0.3, then 0.7, and if I will change the order of factors like 0.7 and 0.3, the product will be same. The second property, the product of decimal or one is decimal itself. When you will multiply 0.6 with 1, the product will be 0.6. The third, the product of decimal and 0 is 0. So students, this is all about your chapter. Prepare your chapter. Thank you and have a nice day.